Welcome to Deep Learning and Neural Networks with Python. I'm your instructor, Frank Kane, and I spent 9 years at Amazon.com and IMDb.com building and managing some of their best-known features. Product recommendations, people who bought also bought top sellers and movie recommendations at IMDb. All of these features required applying machine learning techniques to real-world datasets, and that's what this course is all about. I don't need to tell you that artificial intelligence, deep learning, and artificial neural networks are the most valuable technical skills to have right now. These fields are exploding with progress and new opportunities. This short course will tackle deep learning from an applied, practical standpoint. We won't get mired in notation and mathematics, but you'll understand the concepts behind modern AI and be able to apply the main techniques using the most popular software tools available today. We'll start off with a refresher on Python and the Pandas library, in case you're new to them. Then we'll cover concepts behind artificial neural networks. Then you'll dive right into using the TensorFlow library to create your first neural network from scratch. And we'll use the Keras library to make prototyping neural networks even easier. You'll understand and apply multi-level perceptrons, deep neural networks, convolutional neural networks, and recurrent neural networks by the end of this course. And at the end, a quick final project will let you practice what you've learned. The activities in this course are really interesting. You'll perform handwriting recognition, sentiment analysis, and predict people's political parties using artificial neural networks using a surprisingly small amount of code. If you're a software developer or programmer looking to understand the exciting developments in AI in recent years and how it all works, this course is for you. We'll turn concepts right into code using Python with no nonsense and no academic pretense. Building a neural network is not as hard as you think. All you need is some prior experience in programming or scripting to be successful in this course. The general format of this course is to introduce a concept using some slides and graphical examples. Then we'll look at Python code that implements the concept on some real or fabricated data. You'll then be given some ideas on how to modify or extend the code yourself in order to get some hands-on experience with each concept. The code in this course is provided as an IPython notebook file, which means that in addition to containing real working Python code that you can experiment with, it also contains notes on each technique that you can keep around for future reference. If you need a quick reminder on how a certain technique works, you'll find this an easy way to refresh yourself without rewatching an entire video.